Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I'm excited and I'm feeling great anticipation to show you an app that you have been asking me a lot to show you, which is Google's new Inbox. I finally received my invite and I've got Inbox running on my mobile devices and on my desktop. It's there right here. You can see it right behind me right now. What do I think of it? It's interesting. Stick around and discover why today on Dotto Tech. Today we're looking at Inbox, which is Google has kind of set the stage for us by promoting it, telling us that it is the end of email overload. It's not the end of email overload. The only way we're going to have the end of email overload is if people stop sending us stupid stuff and stuff that we don't need or we get less busy. Email overload is still going to happen, but the Inbox is a new way to approach it. Now, I got to start out by filling you in on really what Inbox is. Inbox is really a new email client, probably designed more for your mobility platform than your desktop platform, but it does, you can use it on all of your smartphones, on your tablet, and on your desktop computer as I have it here. It doesn't necessarily replace, it doesn't have to replace Gmail, but it can replace Gmail for you. So this is my account. So here's my account in Gmail, and here's my same account in Inbox. Now what Inbox is gonna try and do is it's gonna try and tie and include reminders and tasks a little bit more in the interface. So they're trying to give us a little bit more functionality, but they're also trying to give us a different view. They're also trying to give us a different way of looking at our data and our information and our email as it comes in. So I have had a lot of praise for Gmail in the past because of these here along the top, these tabs, which basically allows Gmail to filter through our email and recognize our patterns of using our email and then automatically direct email into these different tabs of social, promotions, updates, and my Prime email, which contains all of the main email that I'm interested in. Inbox does the same sort of thing. It groups emails together in emails that have different common threads running through them. And it doesn't just do it on those big area things, but it does it on smaller, on a more granular level, much like nested emails. If you have nested email where you follow a thread through, much like that, but it'll do it now with multiple emails all being put into that one little nest, if that makes sense. But the big thing I think that they're trying to present is, first of all, the cleaner interface. That seems to be a big theme these days of whitening up the interface and making your screen less cluttered. Jury's out on how valuable that is. But that is one part of it. And the other part of it is adding some additional functionality to the email puzzle. And so they do that with a couple of different features that kind of jump out and we notice right away. The first is at the very top of the menu bar, you see right here, we've got something that says, that shows us a pin. So this allows you to pin or create an urgency or an importance to different either reminders or messages in your email that you can then filter through just with a flip of the button here to whatever the most important ones are. So this pinning concept allows you to demark the most important email as it comes in or the most important things you have to do. The other thing is down here in the compose area, sorry, I've got this little bouncing side sync thing. I'm just gonna quit that in a minute. I'm gonna be showing you this on my mobility device in just a few moments. But the other thing is in the compose area, first of all, it looks at who you've been writing email to the most recently and it brings them up as options. But right above it is a new feature. This is reminders. When I click on this, I create a reminder and I can attach a time to that reminder, which basically makes it kind of like a task that I can assign to myself and I can pin to the top of my list. So it's always there and I'm always being reminded of it. So for example, right now I have to do something with my house insurance. So I'm gonna type in house insurance because I have to renew it and I'm gonna put that in and save it. And so now every time I open my email or look at my email, I have my house insurance reminder pinned to the top. And if I wanted to put a date and a time on it, I could do that. And if it's something that I finished, I can mark it as done. So it does create a bit of a to-do list mentality to your email. And that's not a bad thing. So many of our tasks and to-dos come out of our email. So this ability to be able to manage those tasks right within this email interface, I think it's overall a pretty good idea. I mean, if we take a look at my email interface in Gmail, I have worked out a system where I actually have, if I choose any email from anybody here, so let's just choose this email right here, and I've got this little integration with Todoist, so which is my to-do list manager, so I can add this to my to-do list just by clicking here. So the marriage between email and task list manager is one that is not just a marriage of convenience. There's a lot there. They're trying to build it here into the inbox interface. So those are kind of some of the top level things that happen in it. Personally, this view here isn't rocking for me. If we look at what happens in Gmail with the way that our tabs go, and let me just go back into my main inbox. You know, this, I mean, now when we look at it, it is certainly a far less sexy interface, the old one. You know, it's definitely more cluttered, more information dense. Now, I can choose different views, which will make it a little bit less information dense, but I've got a lot going on here. But here's the thing that I am having trouble getting past with the inbox. Inbox is giving me a little bit of graphical indication of what's coming in and where it's coming from. It shows me who's sending me the email. If it's not a person, if it doesn't have an avatar for the person, it puts the first letter of their name to kind of help sort it. I don't know how that helps to sort things, but I have long used color coding in my filters to help me sort things. So what I'm missing when I use inbox, and I haven't, there might be a way to do this, I just haven't found it yet, so maybe in the comments area, if you know how to do this, maybe you can comment it, because I say, Steve, you just missed it. But when I look in here, I color code with these labels the most important emails that come in, things like from my community, from Patreon. I know that if somebody has come in and posted something in Patreon, that's something that I want to respond to right away. So I hone in. I've tuned myself up so that when I open up my email, the first thing I look for is the colored badges of important information coming in that I want to deal with right away. So if somebody from Patreon has sent me a message, they're part of my community that pays for the site, I want to respond to that right away. Similarly, when there's income coming in, that little yellow badge tells me somebody bought something from me. When I see the little yellow badge, I do the little yellow badge happy dance. Woohoo, I made money. So that's one that really makes me happy, and I would miss if I didn't have my little yellow badge in my email coming in. So there's some real practicality, and there's some just kind of me holding on to the past that I'm looking for with these kind of labels and the labeling system that seems to be missing here from inbox. Now you can do the same kind of sorting and adding, you know, moving your mail into different mailboxes here within it by clicking on the side button. But primarily, they try and make you work on a very clean interface very little distraction attached to the interface. We've seen this in Evernote. Evernote's been doing this for a while now, where they've cleaned up the interface. They're getting mixed reviews. Some people love it, some people hate it. The amount of time you spend on the desktop client is probably going to be dwarfed by the amount of time we spend on the mobile client. I really get the feeling that this product is built more for mobility than it is for desktop. And there's nothing wrong with considering that you might want to use Inbox on your smartphone and still use Gmail on your desktop, or use whatever other email client you want to use on your desktop. I think that that is going to be well within the realm of possibility. So let's just jump in and let me show you quickly the app running on my smartphone. And here I'm showing it to you on a Galaxy 5S, the Samsung smartphone. So you can see that there's a real consistency to the interface. It looks very similar to what I was seeing in the desktop interface. Now, for instance, if I take a look at, if I click on my promotions, all of my promotion emails will now come up. The nice thing is I can deal with them very quickly. If I click here, I can actually archive them all and get rid of them all with one click of the mouse. Very nice from that perspective. I can, by clicking on the plus button, I can choose to compose a new email or to create a new reminder. So again, that interface is very consistent. And I can also do swiping, going one way or the other. Now, swiping to the right tells me that I've dealt with something. Swiping, swiping from the right to the, no, from the left to the right. That's what I'm doing with that one. If you go the other way, this is an interesting addition. This will allow you to snooze an email. So this is similar to what we do with Boomerang, or I've shown you in the past with Boomerang. Now, some people love this idea and some productivity people hate this idea, but this is the concept. You don't want to have a cluttered inbox. A clean inbox means a clean mind. So a big way that Google is recommending that we keep our inbox clean is any email that comes in that we don't want to deal with right now, we can just pretend is gone. We send it away and we have it come back to us at some point in the future. Now, I don't hate this concept. I use it a lot for Boomerang, but a good friend of mine who I actually just put together a productivity course with, Mike Vardy, says that's kind of like getting a bill in the mail and say, you know, I don't really want that mail now, putting another stamp on it, sending it to yourself again and making it go through the postal system again to come back to you. And while it's in transit, it's not really real. So there is that idea, but it's, you know, it depends how you use it and how you abuse it. What is unique about this, which I think might end up being very relevant in the future, is this option. Pick a place. So you can not just select a time and a date when the email will be brought back to you, but you can also say a place. Now, you can also use this for reminders. So you can say, remember when I reach the grocery store that I have to get this. So we can do some very much location-based delivery. Similarly, you can have an email. You could say, if you have an e-ticket sent to you, you can say, okay, I don't really need to keep that here right now, but send it to me when I get to the theater. I don't know if that's the best use of it, but it gives you an idea of how it works. And so you can set things up through the location services, which, as I said, is pretty creative and I think going to be pretty compelling. My plan for this is really a first look at this software. I'm going to spend some time with it on my Android phone and on my iPhone, spend some time playing with it, using it, trying to get a little better handle of how it works. I don't hate the email client, certainly. I don't hate the email client at all on the smartphone. I think I like what I see. I'm not sure I like it at all, though, on the desktop. The desktop might be a big old pass for me, and I'll stay with Gmail on the desktop. And on the smartphone, it does have the potential of becoming my main email client. I hope that was useful. If you have comments, please, please, please let us know below. We are a community here on Dotto Tech, and I love to hear your feedback. If you like this app, if you've tested it out, if you don't like it, let us know. And if I've missed something that you think is super important, by all means, tell us, and I'll make sure to pick that up in the next demo. I read every single comment and appreciate all the time that you spend commenting there. There's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is to subscribe to this channel, which we encourage you to do. The second is subscribe to our newsletter so you can hear about all of our live events and webinars. And the third is consider supporting us on Patreon. We are a crowdfunded site. In other words, a lot of the financial support for this site comes from you, the viewers, through Patreon. And there are perks. You do get benefits for giving us a little bit of support. So I encourage you to drop into the Patreon page and have a look. That's it for now. Until next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.